Hello, hello. Welcome to Co-op for Two. Today, Greg and I travel back in time to the 1960s to join the NASA space mission to the moon in Apollo, a game inspired by the NASA moon missions. You are watching Co-op for Two. I'm Jesse. I'm here again with Greg.
Thanks for having me on your channel.
Today we're playing Apollo, a game inspired by NASA space missions, moon missions.
Is that the actual name of it?
Yeah, Apollo, a game inspired by NASA.
They want to get as many words in that title.
Moon missions. It's a bad omen to begin a game that we've now, normally we would sort of learn it. We would learn it ahead of time, teach it.
Normal at this point.
But this game is pretty convoluted and weird, and we've now played it twice. It's pretty quick, but...
Well, we played once, and it was a spectacular...
How many, what did I say at the end of it? How many mistakes do we make? In the dozens.
No. You said, I said, well, I think we got it, and you go, well, I think we made dozens, we made mistakes. And I said, you really? You said dozens. And
in the
like,
dozens.
And then the next thing you came out of your mouth was, all right, we're ready to record.
Well, we like, gotta film it, but this is...
What are you gonna have to...
I mean, this is a game that's not well suited to filming and talking because you don't really you aren't allowed to talk.
There's no real discussion here between the two of us.
And but we're gonna give you a feel for what it's like after two plays, and we're not that confident. And I'm not gonna teach it because there's just too much going on. But you'll get a feel for the chaos of the game. There's one person doing mission control. You can see Greg can't see the state of the ship.
Can't see the line, can you, Russ?
There's a board. What's that from?
National Everyone's Christmas Vacation.
There's a...
Which, it's just after Christmas now. It's a couple days after Christmas. And it's like that movie is watched at least three times.
Those movies are timeless. okay, so here, this tracks where we are on the space. I have to remember to move this. It's hard to remember.
I love the idea of this. I was a little more invested in
it. If you love science and stuff, I mean, I would recommend Terraforming Mars if you love this feel. This game
does... This has nothing to do with whatever.
If you love the theme of science and space and technology, Terraforming Mars. Greg, if there were multiple players, they'd all be on the astronauts team. Part of their game
Jesse's
is
role
timed.
In this game is to fall asleep with nothing really fun to do.
My mission is to remember to do this.
We've already lost. The game is already over.
We're not doing the timing because there's no point to it, especially
I'll say, did you move the action track? And he'll say, I moved the action track, or something like that. Mm-hmm. So there's a Crystal Method song.
A Crystal Meth song?
Crystal Method, which is a band that I really like. They have one of their albums, Vegas, is one of my favorite all-time albums. It's techno music, but I love it. And they have a song that's like, we see, it's like a normal techno song where they say like the same line like 55 times. He's like, we see the earth, Roger, or got it, one or the other. Oh my God, I can't remember now.
All right, you want to go?
We see the earth? Yeah, but they said all over and over again. So when we were playing this before, it was going through my head. But we see the earth. Roger. Got it.
Okay, but anyway, so Greg is going to do his thing and try to achieve all these stages as he gets along. I'm going to be able to communicate when I have to with these tokens.
It's a good thing we have this little slit here, too, so that I can feed Jesse.
Normally, I just feed them back through there, but I got
I saw that I had that little... I got to shuffle these again.
All right, let's make sure we give this in the right order, too. Stage one, stage... All right, stage one. Are you ready to lift off?
I just wanted to bite feet from my NASA crew here.
Ground control to flight crew. You are ready for takeoff. You may now roll your dice. Is that how they do it on the real space station? Is there a lot of dice rolling?
Now, the real space station, actually, one person, one of the astronauts, is specifically trained to make that noise with their mouth. They get like a beatboxer to do it. You ever go on that ride at Disney? No, you've not been to really Disney, probably.
I've been to Disney World several times.
Get out of Dodge. Okay. Well, they have this ride where they like, you like...
The mission, yes, I've been on
Mission
that.
Mars or whatever.
My little niece was too scared to go on it.
You're in like a really tiny little room.
It's pretty cool, yeah. It's pretty cool.
We're not a big fan of the time element of this particular game because it's it doesn't really seem necessary, but we'll see.
Yeah. So the first thing that happens is after Greg rolls his dice, I'm supposed to tell him how many, but we start out everything max, so it's all 10. He's got to put those dice. He doesn't have any choice in this yet. The sixes, he has a choice. And then it's going to cause some missions, some areas of the ship to get damaged.
Okay, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this because I'm going to repair the life support probably first.
Okay,
so this is in the right order. Okay, so Houston, we have that's like more like a plane. If you looked out to your right, Houston, we seem to be experiencing 3 problems with the life support. Over. Copy. I'm on a walkie-talkie.
Copy that. 3 down on life support.
Houston, we've got a couple of 2 problems with the experiment module.
Copy that.
And looks like we've got a faulty communications module here, if you want to look
into
that.
Copy that.
Okay, and I get one of these for having a bonus. Mm-hmm.
Yep, and I'm going to communicate. We don't know what's most efficient, but I'm going to do this right away. I'm going to say we need yellow 2s.
Yellow 2s.
For the experiment. He's got to complete 2 experiments.
Roger that. Yellow 2s. Okay, well, that's a good time to tell me that because I have this. So, I wonder how many...
Yeah, you don't know how many I could have. If I had more comms, I could have told you.
I think I'm going to get... I'm going to spend this to turn this into a 2, and I'm going to hope that all I need is 4. So I'm going to... Houston, we're sending you 4 yellow 2s.
I've advanced you for that mark. Copy that.
Roger on the advanced.
Flight crew, you've got a completed experiment. Nuclear emulsion experiment.
Nuclear. Houston, I believe you mean nuclear.
Nuclear, I believe that's what I said. You must have a broken
Houston, there needs to be something wrong with the comms.
Flight crew, please check your communication device. You're mishearing things.
This is supposed to be time, by the way.
This experiment explored cosmic radiation above the Earth's atmosphere. You get 4 plus minus tokens.
Roger that. Accessing tokens now. Token access completed.
Flight crew, we've loaded up a new experiment. Please have that completed before the end of the flight. That was a quick experiment, like just before you...
Houston, we're going to do a 5 repair to the life support systems.
Roger that. 5 repair to life support.
Okay, so I probably should give you some comm token. Odd numbers, dice only.
Houston, now, we're let me go... just point out, you should have known that 5 was overkill. Is it 5 or is it 3?
I did 5 repair to the life support.
Okay, you should have known, because it was the first round, that it didn't need 5 repair. That's all I'm saying.
That was 3. Yeah, you're
okay,
right.
Okay, just pointing out.
All right, thank you. Houston, thanks for pointing out my error. Houston, we're going to go ahead and give you 6 comms tokens.
Roger that. 6 comms tokens.
Houston, I believe the days we're going to go ahead and end the round.
Sounds good. Flight control, have a good night, and let me just pass on that we need 1s on the next experiment.
Houston, I want to point out how beautiful the Earth looks. We see the Earth. What did you send me a comm?
1s. We need 1s on your experiment.
Houston, I happen to remember that the 1s were a yellow-only item. 1s and 4s, if I believe, on the experiments.
That's roger that, flight control.
Houston, you aren't allowed to tell me that. This is gonna go well beyond this game. It's gonna be just that all day long. Houston, I have to tell you never to get the mozzarella sticks from Burger King. Over.
That is an affirmative flight control. I tried to warn you about that before.
Houston, that's a roger on that. I was warned and did not listen.
I'll give Burger King a little pat on the back. Almost everything that they touch nowadays is just a disaster and terrible, and it's just ruined and more so and more so, and it just gets worse and worse.
Houston, we're going to have to take 2 damages on the flight control module and 3 damage on power distribution.
Copy that.
Houston, would you like to give me any comms information before we proceed into the play round?
Let me see what you got there.
Is this... We should probably start the timer now. This whole game has...
We should start recording. No, it's recording. It's recording.
I meant in terms of the round.
No, we don't even pay any attention to that.
Apparently we don't pay attention to that.
No, you're all set, flight control.
Alright then, I believe...
But I will warn you, flight control, you must complete stage 2 in the next 2 turns.
I am well aware of that.
You are now.
It all have to be the same. I was aware of that. So... 1, 2, 3... Yeah, let's do this. Houston, we're going to be using up some of our tokens here so that we can complete this stage... Ricky Tick.
Oh, nice work, flight control.
That's what we've been to school for.
All right, you've completed
Houston, stage we've completed two. Houston, we've manually fired the engines to change our course for rendezvous with the unmanned Gemini Agena target vehicle, the GATV, as I'm sure you know, orbiting Earth.
Copy Boing. That.
Boing. That's usually my submarine noise. I guess that's not mm-hmm. me.
You're not in a submarine.
Roger that. I'm not in a submarine. I am in a submarine of sorts. What do we got here? Okay. Houston. I can't do this until the next stage, though.
Correct.
So we're going to do... Houston, we're going to give you 10 comms tokens.
Is it really 10?
Mm-hmm. 5 and 5. 10. Mm-hmm. 2 5s. 10. Mm-hmm. Houston, I did tell you it was 10 comms tokens.
It's just a lot of comms tokens. It's kind of crazy.
Houston, I got to feed them through your little slot. Houston, I don't want to hear any requests for comms tokens for the rest of the game. It's like I sent you a bunch of calling cards. Maybe you could indicate to me what... I guess if I had other partners here, I could indicate that I'd like to repair some systems.
Okay. What I want to remind you is that rather than throwing away dice, you might as well always shift them.
I know what they are. I know what any they
are. Ah, flight control. You could just let me finish what I'm saying. Please don't step on the party line.
Houston, maybe give me an indication as to what I can repair.
Flight control, you can... experiments are on 6. Power distribution is on 5. Everything else is in good shape. Let's see. So you gave me stuff. I got to advance you. I've now entered stage 2.
Houston, I'm going to have you go ahead and do a 5 repair on the power distribution module.
Roger that.
Houston, I'm going to close out the day and we're going to do a re-roll on this.
All right. Flight control, you are clear to go to sleep and have a good night.
Well, it's a great view from up here, Houston.
Roger that, flight control. It's a great view from the ground.
Houston, we've got just an update on the system levels.
Mm-hmm. Go for system levels.
System levels on the... Looking like we have some problems here, Houston, on the power distribution. We're going to have to take a look at that when we get back to base, as that seems to have taken a few hits last round as well. 3 damage to the power distribution modules. I'm getting a visual right now on that
Roger
system.
That. Flight control, you can keep the conversation concise. No need for extra flavor. Just give me the details.
Houston, it looks like we've taken one hit to the life support and one hit to the communications, which should make you happy since you don't want me talking so much.
Roger that.
Okay, let's take a little look-see here again. Okay, Houston, you can go ahead and start the timer, please.
Mm-hmm. Roger that.
Houston, I'm going to go ahead and access 4 of these tokens.
Roger that. Flight Control, you're clear to begin working on stage 3. Rendezvous and dock with target vehicle.
Let's do... Houston, I've placed some, we started maneuvering the Gemini vessel.
Good work, roger that. I've got a communication for you, Flight Control. Your life support's looking good, but it is on 7 in danger of dropping.
Houston, go ahead and take a 3 bump up to the life support system.
Roger that.
Houston, I'm going to send you 2 yellow ones for the experimentation.
Roger that.
That experiment, I think I forgot that actually. That experiment's coming along quite nicely. Houston, I'm going to go ahead and close the day out.
Roger that, Flight Control. Have a good night.
Houston, looks a little rocky up here. Looks like we've taken a couple damages to the flight control. 3 to the power distribution. I'm afraid that might end up being a crisis situation. 2 to the life support and 1 to comms. Not a good round. A lot of things tied up in the Gemini vessel maneuvering.
Roger that, stage 3. Flight control. We've got power distribution on level 2. Dangerously close to crisis.
Roger that.
Also, I'd like to point out, Flight Control, life support is now at a 6, which means you will be rolling less dice next time.
Life control and power distribution, right?
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I get to put these, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. So.
Flight control, I'd also like to give you an update on the communication systems. It's all the way down to a 5.
Roger that, Houston. We're going to go ahead and complete stage 3 at this time. We've maneuvered the Gemini vessel with the engine burns to manually dock and undock with target vehicle. As you know, this is an essential element of the mission to the moon.
I do know that. Congratulations on completing stage 3.
We're going to go... let's see, let's do 6... We're going to go ahead, Houston, and move up 3 on our life support.
Roger that.
And we're going to go up 3 on our power distribution.
Roger that.
Okay, Houston, we are in for the night.
Wow, flight control.
Quick update, how many moves do we have, actions do we have until we are on to stage 4 flight control?
5 moves. I'm not allowed to say that. I guess I am allowed.
Yeah, I can see it. It's just more for like the flavor of it. And also to keep the audience involved. God knows who's going to be watching us play this game where you can't even see what we're doing.
You can see completely what we're doing from the top down.
This is going to send us into crisis. I believe we're taking a 3 hit to the comms. Guessing that's going to lead to crisis.
Nope, but it is dangerous.
We're going to be taking a damage to the flight control, life support, and experiments, 1 each.
Roger that.
That's from like two turns ago. Uh-huh. I guess we've been filming this for 20 minutes, so I've taken
down. Comms are down.
Okay. All right, so I definitely wanted to... These need to be created then, so this is not a good round to do. 3, 4, 5. Actually, maybe. How do I get plus or minus 10? I'm going to go ahead and get 1 token. And then I can spend 1, 2, 3, 4. And do. Okay, 1. Make that a 3, 5, and 1. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to spend this and make it a 1. Spend this and make it a 3. Spend this and make it a 5. So we can... Houston, we're just working on our re-entry module here. We're going to be working on firing the engines one last time to enter the Earth's atmosphere at the precise angle for a successful splashdown. By the way, you can't do that. The comms are down.
I'm not giving it to you. I'm doing it.
What do you mean?
I'm doing this.
Oh, okay.
If I didn't, then I can't. Okay. Can't communicate why that was so important, but it was.
Okay. So, that's done. We're going to... Houston, we're going to go ahead and do a 5 repair to the comms.
Roger that, flight control. Sorry we had a bit of communication problem. It's our comm system, but they seem to be working fine.
Great to have you back on the line, Houston. Getting a little lonely up here, although it is a beautiful view. Can you remind Gemini whether or not we've completed our experiments, our 2 experiments?
Flight control, we had a little bit of foul up here, a FUBAR situation with the experiment, and we've lost track of how far ahead that was, and whether you actually completed none or all of it. Can you recheck your records there, see if you got some duplicate records of
Houston, experiment? In this game you seem to be a glorified bookkeeper. You seem to have failed at your task. I believe I did put 3 ones down, but let's just say 2 for the sake of argument.
Well, if you put 3, then it's done.
Okay, well, Houston, if I do think it's 3, we're going to go ahead and spend 1 action anyway to do 1 just to make sure that we are in a good situation there.
2 comm tokens. Houston,
just so we don't forget, can you bump us ahead on the stage number there?
2 comm tokens and 2 plus minus tokens. And that completes our...
Houston, how many times do you think you forgot to move this track forward?
Just once.
Houston, do you think that's accurate?
I think it's fine now. I think it's fine.
Okay, well, Houston, we're tucking in for the night. We're just looking to get ready for our splashdown here, ready to roll our dice.
All right, do that. God bless America.
Houston, we are doing this for the good of all humanity, not just America.
Well, just remember who pays your checks at the end of the day.
Houston, this is a bit of a problem here. We've got
flight control. This is 1961. Please check your privilege and
please flight control.
Show some patriotism, Houston, otherwise we're gonna have to bring you back home a little early.
Houston, we're hitting you with 3 communications damages. Which is not a necessary system for splashdown for some reason. And we're getting a 3 damage to the experiments, which shouldn't be a problem either, since we don't need that to... Oh, we do need that to succeed at our mission here. And we're going to go ahead and need...
What else are you doing?
It was 3 experiments, 3 communications, and 1 life support.
Roger that.
Houston, I just have a quick game rules question here. I'm wondering whether we recycle the comms tokens or we just deplete them and it's done.
Flight control, we've had a little quality control issue with the rule book here, so I can't give you a clear answer on that yet.
Roger that.
I've got a rules question in case you got some flight control information there. What happens if you want to land way early? It seems like this is
all... Well, we have to go within our orbit. We have to pick our moment. We can't just land the ship when we want to. I'm going to go ahead and maybe work on some repair systems here. We're going to spend this to make this into a 3. And we're going to do a repair of 5 to the life support. Do you want to go ahead and remember this ahead there? That takes care of the life support, hopefully.
So here's an interesting game question. Like, since you're ready to go...
You still have to, like...
I know, but you should eat actions. You should keep from having to re-roll.
Oh, like, that's interesting. All right, we're going to go ahead and do a 5 repair to experiments. Houston.
So these 3 things have to be true by the time he lands. Experiments have to be more than 3. Okay, I'm going to give you a comm. We need experiment repairs that we just said.
I just said 5, so you could have saved that comm token. 4, Houston, 5. That was an unnecessary comm.
Oh, flight control, I'm drowning here in comms tokens. So let's just move you up here. Let me see what else you need. Why have some more?
Flight control.
You've got a 4 flight control. Could use some help there. Actually, not really, but...
Houston, I'm going to do 3 repair to the flight control.
Okay.
Roger that.
And move us forward on that track. Mm-hmm. Houston, we're going to do another two repair to the flight control. Three repair to the flight control.
Roger that.
Houston.
Take it easy. Don't need any flight control. Save your smart
alley. That's a preemptive, judgmental thing that you're assuming I would say something, even though I was searching my mind for something. Okay, so Houston, we're turning in for the night. Going to start a new day out here.
Feels like you can land.
We see the Earth.
While you're sleeping, please consider the power distributions on 2.
What did I say? Don't give me this information right now until I'm done telling you the
power distributions on 2.
I'm not going to remember that. I have to do this. Take them back. I got to do this part first, remember? Mm-hmm. I can't do anything about it until I finish this. Okay, so let's keep the comms and the flight control. Okay, you can tell me that, I guess, yeah. So it's on a 2?
Power distribution is on a 2.
Okay, so... Ooh, I guess I gotta do this then. Alright. Houston, we have a 3 damage level on the flight control. Looking a little rocky coming in for a re-entry here.
Roger that.
And looks like we're not going to have much discussion with you here since the comms are going to take a couple points of damage.
Roger that. Still in acceptable range.
Okay. Looking to get back to our situation here. We're going to use... Houston, if you have any information you want to give us in terms of any... make sure how does our life support and flight control and experiments looking
green
on your end?
On all panels, you are clear to bring her in for a landing.
Roger that. We're going to go ahead and do a 5 repair to the life support.
Unnecessary flight control, as I said. Mm-hmm. All systems are green.
You want to move us ahead on that track, but I can't imagine you've forgotten any less than 5 times.
I can't imagine you just did something we didn't need to be done.
Roger that. We're gonna tuck this shuttle in for a little splashdown. I hope we brought our bathing suits. Houston, as we're gonna be tucking down here in what looks to be in the Atlantic Ocean, mm-hmm. or near the Caribbean. I wonder if that's accurate. Last action, I guess we're gonna do a. Oops, that's a 6. We're going to do a 7 repair to the experiments.
Okay. Roger that. Unnecessary.
And move us on to stage 5. Houston, we have successfully maintained our system while parachutes are deployed to safely land the capsule in the ocean where the astronauts are picked up by a recovery ship. We'll be put the kettle on for us. We'll be coming in for... I don't know. But I have no idea.
Welcome home, flight control. You made it. You have successfully completed the Gemini mission.